What's up, guys? It's your boy Dorian here, back at it again with another review. Today we are reviewing Sonic the Hedgehog, and I am here with my man Vinny. How are you doing today, man?
I'm good, man. I came in specifically to talk about Sonic the Hedgehog. I wasn't even supposed to be here today. But you were like, do you want to talk about Sonic the Hedgehog?
We got to review it, man. So you saw it a couple weeks ago. Can you give me your initial thoughts on the movie now that you have time to sit with it?
So we were talking about this before we went on air. I thought it was perfectly fine, perfectly fun movie. It's family friendly. It's not going to break any barriers. It's not, you know, and it's not gonna blow your mind. It's not like a event movie, but it's fun. And I think everyone did a great job. And it's a shame, I think, and we were just talking about this, how what you think of when you think this movie is that redesign.
Yeah.
It's like the first thing that pops in your head. Like, it kind of reminds me, it's like a failure not in the movie, in the marketing. Like that first trailer came out, Sonic looked like an abomination. He had like teeth, he had like human teeth that I assume he like stole. And it was just like, I don't know, that's what people are going to think.
Yeah.
And I think without that whole, controversy, this would be, it would perform okay. People would be like, that was fun. I enjoyed that. It might get a sequel. Now I think it's going to take a hit because of the marketing.
Yeah, like I'm hoping, I'm praying, because once we actually saw the movie, I really, really enjoyed what I saw. And Sonic, he looked fantastic from start to finish. I think all the visual effects look really good. So I'm hoping, like, word of mouth and us in our review, like, people are going to actually put their money where their mouth is, because I saw a lot of viral tweets about just, oh, this is crap, I'm not going to see it now. But once that second trailer come out, like, I'm hoping people are like, all right, he looks fine.
Yeah.
He looked fine from start to finish, in my opinion. So I'm hoping that all the people that were not on board with this will actually give it a chance.
Yeah, it's not like a cat situation, you know, where it was like, we're sorry, we definitely messed up, we'll fix it, and it like was still terrifying. Like, it was kind of crazy. It's crazy what they're able to accomplish in, I don't know, a few months.
And I think, and with this movie, I felt like, because I grew up kind of playing some of the Sonic games, and it felt like Jeff Fowler, I think this is his directorial debut. Mm-hmm. I thought he did a great job with this being his first movie, especially taking on something ambitious as this. So I thought he was a great director. But I want to give a shout out to, we'll talk about him, Jim Carrey, but Ben Schwartz, AKA John Raphael, Sonic.
Sure.
I thought he was really good as Sonic, because going into this, I was kind of nervous because I'm a huge Parks and Rec fan. Mm-hmm. So going into this, I thought I would just hear Gene Raphael in my head the whole time. But I was like, it felt like he really blended into the character, and he was Sonic.
I had the same thought. Our Collider's animation editor, Dave Trumbore, he this is like his crusade. He hates that animated movies don't hire voice actors anymore. They just hire stars.
Right.
It kind of started with Robin Williams. He did such a good job. People were like, oh, we can have stars play these characters. But I had the same thought. I was like, oh, they hired Ben Schwartz, so I'm just going to hear Ben Schwartz as Sonic. But I think he did a surprisingly good job of like performing as well as being Ben Schwartz. You know what
exactly.
I mean? Like, I feel like a lot of the time, you know, they do like Pixar movies and stuff. They hire this stacked cast, and you just hear that person talking. But I feel like Ben Schwartz did enough to add character to Sonic, which was just impressive. And
sorry to cut you off, but yeah, with him able to like emote his voice through that, and like there were a couple times throughout the movie I was like, wait, that doesn't even really sound like him. It just sounds like he's like actually acting as Sonic. With that accompanied by the actual good visual effects, them making Sonic look having emotion and stuff like that, you really felt empathetic towards Sonic whenever he was going through struggles or anything like that, and you really like could relate to the character, and I was really surprised by that.
And again, like, this movie, it's not a perfect movie. I'm not saying like go see Sonic, this is gonna blow your mind. It's formulaic, it's family friendly, it's easy on the eyes, it's fun. But I feel like I feel like it's almost guaranteed to be better than you think it's gonna be.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, I went in, maybe it's because I went in with like the lowest, again, because of the marketing, I went in with the lowest expectations possible. And it actually does some impressive stuff. There's a chase at the end, I don't want to give anything away, that was like really, it was well done. And it felt like it came from an event movie. It felt like that part of the movie was like, oh, this is the first ever live action Sonic movie, I think.
I believe it is.
And they were like, let's do it up. And in that moment, I was like, oh, I forgot about the marketing. I was like, oh, right, this movie should be a big deal. You know, Sonic has been around for Lord knows how long. It's Sega's biggest character. He's like, I'm not a big, you know, video game player, but to a certain portion of the fandom, he's iconic.
Yeah.
So I feel like people aren't, there's the vibe around this movie isn't as big of a deal as it should be. But there are parts in this movie where you could tell, oh, they wanted to go all out for it. And I was impressed by it.
Yeah, and speaking of the chase scenes and the sonic moments, there were multiple. This is not a spoiler or anything, but there were some really cool moments of him having, like, Quicksilver-esque type of moments where everything is slow and
he's
moving normal.
It was a little derivative. You know, it was pretty much exactly like the Quicksilver stuff.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, I feel like you couldn't do the Sonic movie without having, like, a quick time slow motion scene. And it was well done. It's hard to explain because I don't want to set the bar too high.
Yeah.
Because I feel like the reason I liked it is because my bar was so low. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like I went in not expecting much and it surpassed my expectations. So I want to make sure people know that it's just a really impressively done, fun movie. And I think it'll kill with kids. Like, I mean, the humor isn't, you know, all for me. There's a lot, but it's not for, it's, you know, I'm almost 30. This is the humor isn't for me. It's for kids. And I think this movie will kill with kids if you can get over the fact that Sonic at one point looked horrifying with human teeth.
And with that, I think I got a little bit of flack because I was trying, when we reviewed Doolittle, I was like, this is a kid's movie. I'm not going to hit it as hard. But with this is, I think, Sonic is the epitome of what a family-friendly movie is. I think it has good story beats. It works really well for kids because there, like you said, there were some jokes I was like, I could see that being funny. I didn't necessarily laugh, but then there were other jokes in there that were that I actually felt myself like laughing out loud going with. I was like, they got it.
Doolittle's just a bad movie.
Yeah.
Like, you're allowed to say Doolittle's a bad movie. I think if you're a child, you're like, that was a bad movie. But no, Sonic is it's not anywhere close. And the sense you get is that it's a disaster. But it's not anywhere close to the disaster that that Doolittle turned out to be.
And speaking of the cast, we were just talking about Ben. Let's give a shout out to Jim Carrey. What do you think about his character and his portrayal?
It's interesting because, like, I don't know, man. I grew up with Jim Carrey movie, like when he was on his tear in the 90s. I grew up with that, and in a lot of ways, this is like, you know, a return to Jim Carrey's, you know, his man. And it's fun to see, but it almost feels like he's just picking stuff from his past performances. It's kind of like if like a 90s band came back and was like, we're doing a new album, but it was just like a greatest hits album. Mm-hmm. Like this to me was just like the greatest hits of Jim Carrey, which again is great to see because I don't know, it's been a while since he's been doing dramatic stuff. He's been in Kidding. I think he was in Revenge, which is not a funny movie. He's just been doing his like artsy stuff, and this felt like it felt like all the greatest hits of like The Mask, Dumb and Dumber, Ace Ventura. Like it felt like the Jim Carrey of old with no differences. So it's not like, you know, he's not doing anything new. So it's not exciting and it's not like, oh wow, Jim Carrey's back, but it is cool to see him, you know, returning to that kind of comedy.
Yeah, and I personally, for me, I think he was probably my favorite part of this movie just because of how over the top he was in terms of the story itself. I thought he, like, for me, he stole pretty much every scene he was in. It's so ridiculous, but it worked for me.
This is not coming from any information or evidence or anything, but you can kind of just assume that this was a directorial debut. And you're bringing in Jim Carrey, and it felt like a lot of the scenes were just like, put Jim Carrey in a room and let Jim Carrey do whatever he wants. And, you know, that's appealing to some places. There are some parts when Jim Carrey feels like he's in a completely different movie from everyone else. I mean, James Marsden mostly plays this movie pretty straight, and I feel like that didn't always work because Jim Carrey is on a whole nother triple level than him, and it didn't really feel like they were in the same movie. But that's what you get when you hire Jim Carrey and you're like, do the mask again. But it's fun. I don't know. It's cool to see Jim Carrey be Jim Carrey again. I've been so weirded out. Not weirded out. I've been so unsure of like what Jim Carrey wanted to do for the longest time. And he's been doing great work. But this is like, oh, he can still turn it on. You know, he can still be on like that.
Would you consider this technically a video game movie? There needs to be like a different differentiating factor, because if you take, for example, Angry Birds 2 is technically a video game movie, and it's qualified as the highest rated movie right now. But I'm like, would you consider this a video game movie?
I would call it a video game movie because not only is it based on Sonic, it kind of has the mechanics of a video game. You know, they have the
rings and shit.
The plot of the movie is that Sonic loses his rings in San Diego, San Francisco.
San Francisco.
One of the sands, and they have to go get it. There's like, you know, it's a road trip goal movie, which, and they have, you know, obstacles along the way. It basically has the mechanics of a Sonic video game, because you can't do a story with just, you can't just adapt a Sonic video game. Because there's no story to it, but I feel like, yeah, I would qualify this as okay. a video game movie.
So
sure.
With that being said, what would you give this a score-wise out of 10?
Score-wise out of 10, compared to other video game movies, which are usually pretty terrible, or just, you know, compared to the vast history of cinema?
Overall.
Overall, out of 10, I'd give it like a solid, and this sounds bad, but I'd give it like a 6.
Okay.
Which isn't, like, I don't know, out of 10... That I guess if this was school, a 60% would be failing. It didn't blow me away, but I walked out of screening like, I'm not mad I saw that movie. You know what I mean? So like, it's a solid 6 compared to, you know, other stuff in theaters, compared to other video game movies. I grading on a curve compared to like the Mario Brothers and Doom. I like an 8.
Okay. For me,
compared to Angry Birds 2, which is my favorite movie in the world. I know that's like your favorite.
Hey,
film
Angry Birds 2. Angry Birds 2 is a hit.
I will not bring that up. That is a sore subject. I apologize.
But I'd probably give it a 7.5 or 8 out of 10 on my end. And if we're comparing it to other video game movie, I think I'm on the same 8.5 or something like that. But overall, I personally, walking out of it, like you said, I was pleasantly surprised with how much I enjoyed this, because going in, lower expectations, but walking out, I kind of enjoyed what I was watching. So that's pretty much our review. And also, before we stop, I just want to say, I saw a lot of trolls online, Birds of Prey trolls and stuff like that, saying go see Birds of Prey versus this movie. But I just feel like you don't need to tear down
both.
Yeah, you can see both. You don't need to tear down
they
one.
Both rule.
And they're also shooting at two different demographics.
Yeah. Also, like, Birds of Prey is rated R.
But yeah, like, kids are not like, kids shouldn't be going to see Birds
Although
of Prey.
I feel like, to review a completely different movie, I feel like if your child is 12 and up. Especially if she's a young girl, bring her to see Birds
of Prey.
Go see
Birds
I don't think it's
Prey.
That bad, and I think that you can bring your teenage daughter to see Birds of Prey.
Go see both.
Yeah, and then
don't
bring your younger kids
other.
To see Sonic.
But that's pretty much our review, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Are you going to go see Sonic? Let us know in the comments below, and make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. Peace up, A-Town down. Also, save your comments. Like, if you have any negative comments for me, it's Black History Month, so save them until March 1st. Direct them to Vinny, please.
I can shoulder the burden for this month.
Thank you for watching, guys.